All right, so I've had some athletes asking, they're iron deficient, and they're wondering, hey, should I go out and still push myself, even though I'm iron deficient? Can I hurt myself doing that, or how do I get back to training after having been iron deficient? And one thing I would say is, yeah, we don't want to push our bodies max effort, overdo physical activity when we're in a state of essentially low oxygen or iron debt. I wouldn't be going for a PR. I wouldn't be maxing out my heart rate because that's gonna be really, really stressful on our being. And if we don't have enough iron, we don't have enough oxygen floating around. And this is not just for somebody who's anemic. This could just be simply iron deficiency without anemia. So your hemoglobin could be completely normal, but yet you're iron deficient. And thankfully, young bodies and young hearts are super resilient, and are able to come back from a lot of stuff and figure out how to get around a lot of things. But trying to train at your peak level while you're iron deficient, it really can set you up for muscle injuries, for cardiac dysfunction, and you're putting so much more stress on a beautiful muscle known as your heart. And this has been shown, like I said, even in independent of hemoglobin levels to be an issue, where there's extra stress on the heart, extra stress on the musculature, because these tissues simply cannot get enough oxygen. They cannot get enough energy. So you don't actually have to be anemic. You can simply be iron deficient as an athlete, and especially as a female athlete. And sure, your performance is down, and you're not recovering as well, and you're tired all the time, and your heart rate, you can tell, is way faster than it normally is. But for the iron deficient athlete, the harder you work, the harder your heart has to work, and the more oxygen is needed, and the less oxygen your body's gonna be able to get around, throughout your whole body when you're in an iron deficient state. So both the Krebs cycle, which you may have heard of before, and the electron transport chain, these two massive ATP creators, energy currency creators of the body, are dependent. They're not independent. They are dependent on iron. And so if you can't make the energy currents of your cells, or make enough of it because of iron deficiency, then you're really putting a lot of stress that is not necessary and undesirable on your body. Literally, your body will be in essentially a state of tissue hypoxia, which is basically where there's not enough oxygen for that tissue to do what it wants to do. And those tissues get ticked off when there's not enough oxygen present. So yeah, be sure, start training slow, get back into it slowly. Don't be trying to go, 90%, keep that 70% or so of max, and as you're getting your iron renewed. Otherwise, yeah, for sure, you could end up in a place where you mess up your muscle tissue, get a muscle injury, you cause way too much oxidative stress on the heart muscle. And a lot of people, they're exercising like crazy right now. They don't even realize they're iron deficient, and which stinks. Plenty of these runners out there are running, doing their best, putting out all this energy, and yet they're iron deficient. They're maxing out their heart rate, and it's super unfortunate because they could be potentially injuring themselves and be completely unaware. And then the recovery time from that is going to be even longer than it would be if we just slow down, get iron levels up, get our body recalibrated, and then get back to business. And then we'll be for sure hitting PRs. We will for sure be running way faster, getting way better times when we have sufficient iron levels, and that tissue hypoxia is, a thing of the past. All right, I hope this helps. Let me know your iron stories. Let me know how you had made the comeback and got yourself back on the right track after being iron deficient. Love to hear it.